Membership has its privileges. Membership into the end time army of God. Not membership into a church body. Not that. That membership will only give you potlucks. You all never have potlucks in your church? Yes or no? Then why do you give me the look as if you all are so holy saints who never have potlucks? You just fast and pray all the time. Look at your faces. You have potlucks, don't you? Right. We don't want that kind of membership. Do you? You should become a member of God's end time army. The remnant church. Who will experience all the glories of God for one final display. You know, the days of apostles are not the last days, but the beginning of the end. We are on the tail end of the end times. And the Bible says in Haggai chapter 2 verse 9, the latter glory of this house shall be greater than the former, says the Lord of hosts. And in this place I will give peace, declares the Lord of hosts. Now if you look at this scripture very carefully, two words are mentioned there. There are two time shifts in God's house. The first is called the former house. The second is called the latter house. Now what is the former house? See, God will pour out the glory on the former house. That took place on the day of Pentecost in the first century. Acts chapter 2 verses 1 to 4 tells us when the Holy Spirit was poured out upon the former house. It gave birth to the church. And all the nine gifts of the Holy Spirit manifested powerfully. The nine gifts of the Holy Spirit and the fear of God manifested so powerfully that within a short time, from 120 members, the church grew to 8,120 members. Just two sermons that were preached a short time. And how did this exponential growth took place? Largely because of signs and wonders. Not because of programs in the church. Today we have great programs in our churches. Men's fellowship, women's fellowship, children's fellowship, singles fellowship, doubles fellowship. If there is single, there should be a double, you know. Right? Parents fellowship, grandparents fellowship, widows fellowship, all kinds of fellowship. All that is to entertain the club members. It just entertains the club members. Because once you become a member of a club, you pay your dues, you pay your tithes and your offering. That's your membership dues. And then you must have some activities to justify for all that you have received. Now with all those programs, tell me honestly, how much has your church grown? The early church had no such membership privileges. Nothing. No men's club, no women's club, nothing. They went everywhere preaching the gospel of the kingdom. As you heard Brother Neville share yesterday. They preached the gospel of the kingdom and they demonstrated the power of the living God. One miracle done by Peter for a man born lame at the gate Beautiful before he entered into the temple. One miracle brought a huge harvest into the church. And then another miracle, several miracles took place, and another huge harvest came into the church. And if you look at the pattern of the life of the Lord Jesus, he preached the gospel of the kingdom, followed by signs and wonders following.